Black people with white minds, you know. Sudan is very competitive. What I call it a political Arab. It is not a real Arab, but political Arab. Some people think that you are Arab, okay? And you are from family of the Prophet Muhammad, because all of Arab, you know, they say that their grandfather is Muhammad the Prophet. And because a lot of them think that when you are Arab and you are from Muhammad family, you know, we have no white man or white woman in Sudan. Sudan means, Sudan in Arabic means the black, you know. And this name came from Arab people and Turkish. They call us Sudanese, Sudan, Bilad Sud. That means the country of black people, you know. So I have never in my life see a white Sudanese. This white, them being white in Sudan is a political. No, this is just a, you know, I do not know how it comes, but if anybody reads the history of slavery in the world, he knows a lot of people were white, although they were slaves, you know. There are many also, or there were many black people who were masters of slaves. I don't know what I can call it in English. But we have all kingdom in Sudan, Isinar, what we call Isinar, and we call it in Arabic Sultan Zarqa. You know, those people were black people. But although they were very black people, like every other people in Sudan, they took others as slaves because they have power. You know, not saying that black people are slaves and white people are masters. I know, you know, Mauritania case is very complicated, because until now there are markets for selling people. And we saw this in media. There are too many girls, they were for sale, you know. And if you want to buy these, and she can do so and so for you, and they describe her, and she is from where and where and where, and you have to pay, you know, some money to buy her. And this is, you know, very late, you know. I think when we speak about slavery now, there is no slavery, but there is what we call, or some people think they are Arab, okay? They are Muslim Arab. And everybody who is not Muslim Arab is slave a lot. They do not communicate with other nations. They do not, even a lot of them, they didn't go to Europe or to other countries. So as to see, you know, to investigate whether they are black or white, you know. Actually, they are black, you know. They are black. And I'm sure if any woman or any man from Mauritania or from Egypt or from any other country, so-called Arab country, even from Arab Peninsula, and come here, they call him black man. Call them Bedan, but actually they are not, you know. And this is, you know, just an imaginary idea. In Sudan also the same. See, some people say, yeah, you are black man. And what about you? He may say, I'm white. And I will tell you very strange story. You know, there is a very famous man in Sudan, you know, a minister of something in Sudan, high rank, you know, has a lot of money. And he went to Mauritania, okay? And he met a woman there. He is also a minister of something. I do not know, I didn't understand. I didn't remember that. And she was very pitiful, because he was in his mind that he's a white man. You know, as he ranked himself in Sudan. Then he asked her if she can agree to marry him. She said, no, you are a slave. In Sudan, this guy is a white man, you know, and from
In Mauritania,
he's a black man. In Sudan, his grandfather is Muhammad the Prophet. In Mauritania, his grandfather is Bilal. I call it political Arab. Because when he say I'm Arab, I'm Muslim, and Muhammad the Prophet is my grandfather, he just wants something very specific, something very identified, you know, something very special. He wants money, you know, wealth, and he wants power. When he speak about his history, about his grandfather, grandmother, and Islam, and so, he just mean he must be the master of power, and that he has to be master of wealth, you know? That is what he wants. So power and wealth is politic. And he want to lead. He want to be the president. He want to be, you know, the leader of parties. He want to be the leader of everything because his grandfather is Muhammad. So for me, it's not speaking Arabic or writing Arabic. For me, is not a problem because, you know, people in Mauritania, as you said, speak French, and some people in some African countries speak English language. And some people speak Spanish. This language were European language. But Arabic is Afro-Asian. Afro-Asian, it is part of it, African language and Asian language. And when we speak Arabic, and when we deal with Arabic, you know, as Sudanese, Arabic is not matter of, not matter of what we can call colony, you know,
mm-hmm.
Arab people are not colony. They are not. They were not came with guns or something like that. Sudan, they didn't conquer us. When they come to invade Sudan from Egypt, we defeated Arab people. You know, we were Nubian and defeated Arab people. You know, and they ran away to Egypt and somewhere else. You know, and at that time was Abdullah ibn Abi Sarh, very famous Islamic leader. He couldn't enter Sudan, you know, as a fighter or as a conqueror. And Arab people came to Sudan in late after maybe 400 or 500 years after that, came from Darfur, you know, came from Darfur, from Western Sudan, enter Arabic to Sudan. And Islam also entered by that way. But it is very peacefully. They came as shepherd, you know, rearing camels or cows or something like that. But when came the politic, you know, the political people, and they won't change the demography of Sudan, so the war started. I told you they want to dominate us because two reasons, you know, power and wealth. For this reason, I called it political Arab. You know, now DNA for everybody can go to any hospital and check his DNA. If he is Arab or not Arab, if he's African, if he is Fulani, or if he's Nubian, or a lot of Sudanese went there. They thought before they were Arab. And when they made this DNA check, they were from Western Africa and Eastern Africa. A lot of them came from Africa, and that is a fact. We are African, we are Nubian, you know? But Arab is, you know, language, and to some extent, culture, and because of the religion, you know, Quran written in Arabic, so a lot of people like to be Arab, not because they are really Arab. They are Muslim, and then when they want Sudan to be a Muslim country, an Arabic country, and so to segregate the non-Arabic people so as to avoid them to have their power from the wealth, you know, from the power, and they want to lead. And this cannot be well established in Sudan, okay? Now, the Arab people are, you know, what, or what so-called Arab dominated Sudan. In Sudan, we were not descendant of slaves. For example, my tribe is Masalid. We have no one slave registered in our history. We have our kingdom. We were fighters, you know? And even we fought against French people and we defeated them in two big wars. And in 1919 and in 1918, you know, we defeated French people in two times. So, and also too many other tribes, black tribes in Sudan, they were not slaves. They were not descended of slaves, you know. That is a problem. But, you know, some people, when they see us, we are black people, they think we are slaves. Actually, we were not. Yellow people in Sudan, what you call white people, their fathers, you know, a lot of fathers of those people, you know, not all the people, you know, some people are Sudanese, you know, Sudanese, but some of them descended from fathers from other countries, you know, came from Turkish or European or something like that. And also for this yellow colors, it is not only also European, but a lot of them descended from Amazigh, barbarian. You know, the origin of a lot of African tribes were Amazigh from Northern Africa. You know, Mauritanian people have to fight back against this government, you know. They have to defeat them. They have to be, you know, to join their parties, to fight for the freedom, and to emancipate themselves, you know, from these governments. I know a lot of people in Mauritania were Fulani, a lot of people from Amazigh, from too many, you know, tribes. They were free, and they are free, and they will be free until the end of this life.
Thank you, Abdelaziz. Thank you very much.